हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम इनटू द सेकंड लेक्चर ऑन एटॉमिक एब्सॉर्प्शन स्पेक्ट्रोस्कोपी। इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव सीन द बेसिक प्रिंसिपल ऑफ द एटॉमिक एब्सॉर्प्शन स्पेक्ट्रोस्कोपी। सो इन टुडेज लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट the instrumentation of the atomic absorption spectrophotometer. See the schematic diagram of atomic absorption spectrophotometer which is shown in this following figure. Okay. In this case, see first component of the atomic absorption spectrophotometer is the radiation source. Okay, this is the in yellow circle there will be the radiation source which is called as hollow cathode lamp. Okay, hollow cathode lamp. Second component is the wheel like structure, that is rotating chopper. Okay, this is the rotating chopper. This is the second component of this atomic absorption spectrophotometer. Third one, the burner. See, this is the burner. This burner, you all of you know, we have seen in flame emission spectroscopy, right? Okay, so this is the entrance slit. This is the monochromator, or you can say prism. This is the exit slit. This is the photo cell, or you can say photo tube, or you can say photo multiplier tube, or we can say detector. This is the electronic amplifier, right? This one is the readout device. These are the all components of an atomic absorption spectrophotometer. Okay, now we will see one by one, in short, their functions. Okay, this is the radiation source which is called as hollow cathode lamp. For that, there is power supply of this bulb, or you can say lamp. Actually, this hollow cathode lamp we can use for the radiation source or atomic absorption spectrophotometer, and it should emit stable intense radiation of the element to be determined. That means whatever element we are going to determine, or you can say analyze, with the help of this instrument, that type of metal, or you can say that metal will be used to prepare this radiation source. Okay, resonance radiations are obtained by using a hollow cathode lamp as a radiation source. Okay, this is the main purpose of this hollow cathode lamp. It should emit the stable and characteristics resonance wavelength, or you can say light, from this radiation source. In detail we can see later on. Now the second component is the chopper. Okay, this is actually rotating wheel, okay, which is placed in between this radiation source and the burner. Okay, in between these two we have placed this rotating chopper, which is wheel like structure, right? So the chopper is employed between the hollow cathode lamp and flame. A chopper is a rotating wheel of such shape that it permits the beam to pass through during one half of its period of rotation. Okay, when it's one half of period of rotation, it will pass the light which is coming through this radiation source and the flame. Okay, actually its function is, it is used to eliminate emitted radiation, unwanted radiation by this flame that will be nullify or cancel with the help of this rotating chopper. This is the main purpose of this chopper. Okay, in detail we can say later on. Okay, so third component is the burner, or we can say furnace, or we can say atomizer. Okay, either this burner we can use the graphite furnace. We have seen two types of burners in flame emission spectroscopy. Out of that two, this one is the total consumption burner. Okay, so what's the purpose of this burner? This burner will be used to burn our sample solution. In this, there is our sample solution is there. Okay, this sample solution will be burned through this burner and the atom will get excited. Okay, then further that atoms will get analyzed. Okay, this is the purpose of the burner. Now this one is the entrance slit and this one is the exit slits. Okay, this entrance slit will be cut off. Okay, polychromatic light or unwanted radiations coming through this flame, okay, that will be cut off. Only single beam of light will be passed through this entrance slit and that will be reaches to this prism, or we can say monochromator, or we can say grating. That single beam of light will be passed on this monochromator that will be convert into the single beam of light and pass through this exit slits. Okay, then that single beam of light, or you can say selectively characteristics of light of particular element only pass through this exit slit and falls on this photocell, or you can say phototube, or you can say detector. Okay, so detector will be detect whatever light coming through the prism and convert into the electrical signal. Okay, that signal will be amplified by this AC electronic amplifier. After amplification of that electrical signal into this, that signal will be read into this readout device. Okay, this is the instrumentation of the atomic absorption spectrophotometer. Okay, so now we will see the first component, that is our radiation source. Okay, radiation source, just in I have told you the radiation source, that is hollow cathode lamp. So this is the figure of the hollow cathode lamp. So see, in this figure the pinkish is the hollow cathode lamp. At the left hand side, from the power supply is there, and C like structure in between this, that is the hollow cathode, or you can say hollow cathode cup. Around there is two parallel lines are there, that is glass shield, and now outer part of that will be the anode. And right hand side there is quartz or pyrex window. Okay, that will be used for the falls of light. And inner part of that hollow cathode lamp will be filled by inert gases like neon or argon, which is having the pressure at about 1 to 5 torr. Okay, So this is the simple figure of that hollow cathode lamp, which is used as a radiation source in atomic absorption spectroscopy. Okay, now we will see what is that, what will be use of this radiation source and the inner working of this radiation source. So the radiation source for atomic absorption spectroscopy should emit stable intense radiations of the element to be determined, usually a resonance line of the element. Okay, that means whatever element we are going to analyze, that element used to prepare this radiation source, we can say hollow cathode lamp. Resonance radiations are obtained by using a hollow cathode lamp as a radiation source. It consists of a hollow cathode cup, which is C, made up of element under study, or it may be constructed from an inert element into which the desired element or salt of the desired element is kept. Okay, see, either that actually desired element or either salt of that desired element will be kept inside that, or we can say that will be used to construct, okay, this hollow cathode cup material. The cathode is usually surrounded by a glass or porcelain shield, which serves to minimize diffusion of the atoms that are formed in the lamp away from cathode. Okay, in between that hollow cathode cup, there is a glass or porcelain shield is there. Just I told that two parallel lines in between that C type of the hollow cathode cup. A tungsten wire acts as an anode. That surrounded one wire is there, that is will be used as a anode. The two electrodes are enclosed in a glass envelope containing an inert gas, or you can say filler gas, like neon or argon at low pressure, that is about the 1 to 5 torr. Okay, that means whole radiation source, in between there will be one gas field, that is the either neon or argon, which is having the pressure of 1 to 5 torr. The end of the hollow cathode lamp is sealed. That means at the right hand side, I told you the pyrex or quartz window is there, that will be totally sealed with a window of a material that is transparent to the radiation that is emitted by the element on the cathode. Okay, the pyrex window will be the transparent. Okay, that transparent window will be used to force the light on the another component. The window is constructed from quartz or silica or glass material. The silica material, quartz or silica material, will be used for UV regions only, or glass material will be used for visible region. When a DC voltage of 300 to 500 volt is applied between the two electrodes, the atoms of the inert gas are ionized at the anode, and positively charged ions so form are attracted to the cathode. That means when we apply the power supply, okay, or we can say voltage of about 300 to 500 volt, then what will happen? The inert gas are ionized, that we have already filled inside, that is either neon or argon. Okay, that positively ions will be attracted towards the cathode, right? The fast moving ions strike the surface of the cathode where energy of their collection cause the element on the cathode to be transformed into gaseous atom is a process in a process called sputtering. What is the sputtering process? Simply, the fast moving ions of the inert gas that will be strike surface of the cathode where energy of their collection cause the element on the cathode to transform into gaseous atom in a process that is the sputtering process. Absorption of energy from the applied potential and from collision with filler gas ions cause gaseous atoms to get excited to a higher energy state and emit their characteristics radiation. Okay. The neon and argon gas filled in the holocathode lamp performs actually the three major functions. What are that? It is the main source of current carrying capacity, right? What? It is the main source which is carrying a current. Second one, it dislodges atoms from the surface of the cathode. And third one, it is primarily responsible for excitation of the ground state metal atoms. Okay, these are the three major functions of the neon or argon gas which is filled inside into the hollow cathode lamp. Okay, so in the next lecture we are going to see the remaining components of the atomic absorption spectroscopy. So for today, thank you.